Luther Gulick explains the scope of public administration through the English letters POSDCORB, which expands P for planning, O for organization, S for staffing, D for direction, CO for coordination, R for reporting, and B for budgeting. It includes planning of any agenda that the government machinery seeks to implement by working on the methods of implementation. It includes forming various departments and structures like division, subdivision, and other administrative structures, and entrusting roles and responsibilities for each for the achievement of desired goals. It includes recruiting and training the needed staff. It also includes the framing rules and regulations of civil service. It includes providing direction and orders to the various departments. It involves facilitating better interaction between various departments by resolving conflicts by converging their functions. It involves reporting by the officials to the senior officers on the functions of various departments, submitting reports to the legislature by conducting research, documentation, and investigation. It involves managing the financial planning, expenses and income, calculation and auditing. The scope of public administration is increasing in these days. This does both the protective and regulative functions. The growth of civil society further expands the scope of public administration.